Hi, I'm Roxy. Welcome to my channel. Let's see what you need to know. So, someone got choked up on something, but I feel like some of you really need to get rid of something. Flush that shit down the toilet. Look, there's even a toilet and there's shit in it that needs to be flushed. Use that plunger and get rid of it. Like, someone really needs to end some kind of connection or end some kind of stuff that's been going on that you're keeping closed off and not trying to acknowledge. Just get rid of it, because this is just holding you back. It could be multiple people that you need to get rid of. Like, they wear a mask and they're just hiding themselves to you. Something's not, like, you're trying to focus on something, but there's other connections or something that is disrupting something. And I feel like you're worried as well about a certain someone or a judgment that might have been had. I feel like someone had their tower moment, and this could be the tower moment that all of a sudden you're worried about someone, worrying about an ending. Something's on fire. Something came in and lit a fire on someone's ass, because someone's definitely flushing some shit down the toilet. Like, they're clearly over this fake facade bullshit. I feel like you realizing this, that these people are starting to show themselves to you. Like, you're realizing they're just in it for the money or in it just to win it. Like, they're not even really there for you. And you're realizing this. I think this is a shock. So this could be people that you are close to, quite possibly lived with, or could be old friends from the past. You were hanging out and doing some things with them, and you're like, you're realizing they aren't who they used to be, or they aren't who they put themselves out to be. And I feel like a lot of you are taking off from this. Like, you're done with it. Someone's definitely worried about something though. I feel like some of you also are having trouble communicating as well. Like, I definitely, like, you want to say something to someone. You, like, you have something on your chest you want to say, but you're afraid to come out and say it. Yeah, you definitely have some, like, someone is going to come in and give some kind of information. Like, this old guy's showing the swords, and swords represent truth, thoughts. Like, someone's coming in to tell somebody some kind of truth. This also could be the tower moment. Like, you didn't see this coming. Like, all of a sudden somebody is just gonna open up and say what they've been hiding, say what they have not been saying. Some of it could be bad news as well. Be careful what this person tells you. Use discernment when you're hearing this information as well. Careful who you tell your business to, because I feel like someone's also taking the information that you're giving someone and they're relaying this to someone else. Again, these people who pretend to be your friend, they're just a joke, a big freaking joke. They're playing it with you. They're definitely playing games with you, and they know that they can get away with it. But I feel like you're definitely on your guard now. Like, I feel like you're definitely realizing that people are watching you. Like, you have multiple people watching you, and you're realizing that some of these people that you're watching is just hiding behind some kind of mask, some kind of cloak. And I feel like you're starting to put your antennas, so to speak, is starting to, like, peek up and say, okay, I really need to pay attention to my surroundings more. Yeah. I feel like you're definitely paying attention to your surroundings more. You're careful with your hands and what you say as well. You're starting to realize that your information that you've told certain people is getting out, and now you're realizing you don't want to just reveal your hand to just anybody. Yeah, now you're definitely closed mouth now to certain people because you're realizing that these people that you've told your ish to or whatever going on in your life, you're realizing that it's getting out to other people and you didn't tell these certain people that you're hearing it from. This might have been about a feminine energy that you were dealing with, that somebody had told some information that you said about her to others. There's definitely somebody that is the leader of the pack that is really trying to, they control these people, like they get them to do their bidding. Could be a mother figure for some of you as well. Yeah, I feel like this feminine energy is telling your ish to other people. This could be a friend. A foe is what I heard, not a friend. She pretends that she's a friend. You might be a little more than just friends. This could be one of your connections. So you might have multiple connections, but one of these definitely uses her cookie for getting what she wants, I feel like. And she definitely likes to spill her ish or everybody's ish that she connects with to other people. Like, she doesn't keep her mouth shut. Also heard she doesn't keep her legs shut, but no offense to anybody. I definitely feel like there's a lot of sexual activity that's going on with multiple people. And this person holds this over your person or you. They hold this over your head. Like, they're gonna tell whoever that they're doing something with you. And you fear this, or this could be your person. They fear that this is gonna get out, that they've had multiple connections on the line, and this is how they keep them from moving on. His truth. He has, or you have some ish that you don't want to get out, but I feel like it's already getting out and you're realizing this person is using you, but she's also abusing you, and she's definitely ruining your name, or trying to ruin your name. Like, she's definitely, like, she's holding against you, but then she's out here doing it anyways. Like, she says she's gonna do it. She already is doing it. And I think a lot of you are starting to realize that she's kind of caught herself in a corner because she has no leverage now because she's already told your truth. So what's the point of her keeping you stuck anymore? Because your shit already got out there. But this haunts you. I feel like a lot of you have nightmares of all your stuff getting out. So there could be some information that has yet to get out. Something that you're really worried about, maybe, quite possibly. Or you're afraid that they're gonna lie and say something that's not true as well. That's what you're worried about. I think for some of you that they're making up extra crap to make you really look bad. Like, this person's out here lying on your name is what I'm hearing. And this haunts you a lot. I think you lose sleep because of this. You're afraid that this person's gonna get to these other people and they're gonna believe all the lies that she's been out there saying, or he's been out there saying. A lot of, I feel like it's definitely feminine energy because there's a lot of feminine energy in this reading. Yeah, she definitely likes to use her. She might be a little on the kinkier side, whoever this person is. I don't know, but she definitely uses sex to her advantage. I definitely think, like, she definitely belittles the masculine energy quite a bit. Like, she gets off on doing that to like demasking them. She definitely likes to belittle them and put them in their head, makes them feel less than, because it gives her power and it gives her that rush. Like, she feels like she's on top of the world, or she feels like she can conquer anything when she hurts these people. Like, I hear she treats them like my little bitches. Like, she treats them like slaves. She might have some sex slaves, to be honest with you, some of these people that you are connecting with. She might drink a lot as well. Or she uses some kind of substance quite a bit. Because she has her own ish going on, obviously, if she's going to treat men the way she does. So she has not been treated too well by masculine energy, I feel like. And this is what makes her be like this. Yeah. I feel like a lot of you just feel so broken because of all the crap that's coming because of this feminine energy. Like, she belittles you, she makes you feel less than, and it makes you not want to do anything. I feel like a lot of you are just stuck and possibly dealing with depression at the moment. Like, you just had enough of this, though. I really think a lot of you have had enough of this. And I feel like a lot of you are going to be putting an ending to this feminine energy because you're realizing that all she is a wounded woman who needs some guidance in her life. Yeah, she definitely needs to seek guidance. She definitely has men worshiping at her feet. Like, the way she puts herself out there and the way she treats men, she gets them to do whatever she wants, but she does it in a bad way. It's not even a good way. Like, she uses their weaknesses to her advantage. But I feel like she's gonna eventually, one of these days, she's gonna be like shown. I feel like I heard one of these days someone's gonna come along and, you know, prove her and show her, take her mask off, and she can really see herself in the mirror. And that's gonna shock this woman. Like, she's gonna realize she has to do some work. Some of you, they might try to trap you. So this could be a baby mama as well for some of you. Or this person's gonna try to trap this other person that you're connecting with, or this is you. Because I'm certainly seeing a little swimmers right there. So just be careful, unless you want to have children. But a death trap is what I'm hearing. Like, you're fully knowing. I feel like some of you already knew this person was that type of person, and you're taking this risk anyways because they hold a lot of shit over your head. This could come as a shock for some of you that you did get someone pregnant. Like, it's just something you weren't expecting, even though you knew you were gonna go and poke that beast and get a little something extra. I think a lot of you took, or this person that you're connecting with took that risk, and this person might come along and tell you this, and that's gonna shock you. Or someone might actually end up waking up and realizing this before this happens. And I feel like once you realize that and cut this person out, that's when you're gonna come into your Two of Cups, your soulmate. Because you've seen the light and you're moving past this person because you realize this person is not who they say they are, or you're realizing she's just, you know, she needs help. This personally definitely needs help. Whoever you're connecting with, or your person's connecting with, they have a really bad negative energy about them. They definitely do not care a lot about male masculine energies at all. Like, they definitely like to use them. Someone has a decision to make, and it could be towards two feminine energies. Like I said, this could be your person you're connecting with. This is could be a reason for why you guys didn't start off or at all. Like, they were in this, or they were connecting to this devil energy, this woman who is, like I said, against male figures. Yeah, there's like, this person has a decision to make, whether to walk away from this ish and go towards his true empress, or continue down that road to unhappiness, to possibly, some of you, could be death. Not in a sense like death to my soul, like you're going to be miserable for the rest of your life, and you're going down this path if you continue with this negative energy that you're connecting with. Yeah, but I feel like a lot of you know that there's a rainbow after all this, and you just need to come out of this illusion, so that way you can see that you have a rainbow coming your way. You just got to end it with this negative energy that you're connecting with. Definitely realizing, and there's definitely going to be an ending. I really think, like I said in the beginning, someone's getting ready to flush down this negative energy down where it belongs. Like, they're getting rid of it. They're purging this person. They're not playing these games anymore. They're seeing things for what it is. They're making their judgment. Love and light.